with dementia. They want us to believe that no outside factor can be changed or altered that would alter our fate, that now we're being told is to inevitably get dementia or Alzheimer's, that that's just a part of life, which is a blatant, glaring lie. Trying to pacify the populations into accepting this fate from this report. And this weaves into the rest of this report for this program. Bear with me. There's no proven intervention for preventing late-life dementia. Researchers from the Minnesota Evidence-Based Practice Center reviewed published research to determine if physical activity, prescription medications, over-the-counter vitamins and supplements, or cognitive training interventions could help to prevent dementia in patients who did not have it at the time of the studies. The vast majority of research showed that none of the interventions worked. Findings from 4 systematic evidence reviews are published in the Annals of Internal Medicine, Medical Industrial Complex. No mention, of course, of the environmental factors that we can't hide from, starting with largest factor in the case of aluminum, climate engineering operations, raining aluminum down through our air column. This is lab test proven fact. Massive amounts of aluminum, now proven to be connected to dementia and Alzheimer's as the primary core causal factor, never mentioned in any of these studies, that basically are trying to convince the population that there's nothing you can do. You will get these diseases and you should just accept it. The report continues. The prevalence of cognitive impairment and dementia is expected to increase dramatically as the population ages. Let's stop for a moment right there and remember that the life expectancy in the U.S. is going down, not up. Report continues. Optimal treatment to prevent and delay cognitive decline, mild cognitive impairment, or Alzheimer's type dementia is not known. They're trying to tell the population again, nothing you can do. This agency, the EPC, EPC researchers were funded by the Agency for Healthcare Research and Quality, the AHRQ. Now, let's get to this part of the report. The AHRQ is an administration that the Trump administration proposes to fund with some $378 million. Because this is part of the military-industrial complex's programming of the population to accept their fate. And these agencies are well-funded. And it's not just about the Trump administration. Mr. Trump is just a puppet in the play, as were all previous administrations, all part of the power structure. So when you think or you convince yourself that someone somewhere out there working for the government has your best interest in mind, think again. It couldn't be further from the truth. Let's continue on this theme of Alzheimer's. The Alzheimer's Society states in bold letters on the top of a page they have dedicated to cast doubt in public consciousness about the aluminum Alzheimer's dementia connection. This is the headline on their page. Studies have not provided strong evidence of aluminum being a risk factor for the development of dementia. A blatant, glaring lie. I've stated in previous programs, the Alzheimer's Foundation would not allow me to have a booth at their event with published studies connecting aluminum to Alzheimer's. Why not? Because there's members of the aluminum industry sitting on the Alzheimer's Foundation board. Across the full spectrum, we have the foxes running the hen house everywhere. Again, if you think these agencies or organizations like the Alzheimer's Foundation have your best interest in mind, think again. They're just part of the cover-up to make the population feel good, to feel like they're doing something to stop Alzheimer's, which couldn't be further from the truth. It's like putting a fire out by pouring gas on it. They're ignoring the core causal factors intentionally, not just ignoring, but covering up the core causal factors of these neurological epidemics that are sweeping society. Final statement from the Alzheimer's Society cover-up. They state this, in summary, current research provides no convincing evidence that exposure to trace elements of aluminum is connected to the development of dementia or Alzheimer's. Patently false. So let me get to science study about that now. Here's science study titled, this is peer-reviewed study, aluminum and Alzheimer's disease after a century of controversy, is there a plausible link from this science study? The hypothesis that aluminum significantly contributes to Alzheimer's and dementia is built upon very solid experimental evidence and should not be dismissed. Immediate steps lessen human exposure to aluminum, which may be the single most aggravating avoidable factor related to Alzheimer's and dementia. Let's cover another report on the connection between aluminum and Alzheimer's disease and dementia and other neurological diseases. This one from the Journal of Alzheimer's Disease reports, Volume 1, Number 1, titled, Aluminum should now be considered a primary etiological factor in Alzheimer's disease. From this report, clinical evidence that implicates aluminum as a primary etiological factor in Alzheimer's disease. The unequivocal neurotoxicity of aluminum must mean that when brain burdens of aluminum exceed toxic thresholds, that it is inevitable that aluminum contributes toward that disease. Aluminum acts as a catalyst for an earlier onset of Alzheimer's disease in individuals with or without concomitant predispositions, genetic or otherwise. Alzheimer's disease is not, I repeat, not an inevitable consequence of aging in the absence of a brain burden of aluminum. Not inevitable and directly connected to aluminum from peer-reviewed study. And here we have governmental organizations like those just funded for $378 million from the Trump administration and previous administrations and the Alzheimer's Foundation patently denying the science facts, just like they do with vaccinations, just like they're doing with the climate engineering assault that's dumping, according to the world's most recognized geoengineers, 20 million tons of aluminum nanoparticulates into the skies around the world annually. And this stated goal is likely far less than what's actually happening. Does anyone stop to comprehend how much material it takes to blot out the sun from horizon to horizon, all of which is raining down through the air column?
Now the forecast,
all of which each and every one of us are inhaling out every breath, and we know this. This is not theory, hypothesis, or speculation. We have lab tests to prove it for precipitation. We have soil testing in Northern California to prove that there's so much metal raining down on us, it's actually changing soil pH values in the forest. We have the USDA baselines. I've been over this again and again. This is not speculation. For those that are new to this news program, that are not familiar with why I find myself in this battle, it's because I have a large off-grid solar home. I have a background in solar energy, and I began to lose massive amounts of my solar power uptake. On some days, 80 to 90% of my solar power uptake was being lost due to whatever these aircraft were emitting, which clearly could not be condensation. The condensation trail lie. That's why I find myself in this battle, because once I began to test and find massive amounts of aluminum in my precipitation, starting with a baseline test of 7 parts per billion of aluminum, I immediately spoke to a hydrogeologist who made clear to me I should have less than 1 part per billion, if anything, given my filtered forested location and the fact that there's no industry anywhere near, no roads, no transportation, nothing. Subsequent rain tests in my location on the east side of Lake Shasta escalated as much as 50,000%, nearly 50,000%, to 3,450 parts per billion. Highly toxic rain. If it's in the rain, it's in the air column. If it's in the air column, and it is, we are breathing it. We've done so many tests. This is real. It's affecting every one of us, and we have governmental agencies and organizations like the Alzheimer's Foundation trying to convince us it's all normal, no connection, getting Alzheimer's, dementia, Lou Gehrig's disease, everything. There's so many diseases related to these neurotoxins. It's all just normal, all just a part of aging, which is absolute nonsense. Will we be frogs in boiling water? Will we stand up and make our voices heard and try to turn the tide? That's up to us. Let me continue with this program.
Our sharecroppers on the land. This is why we're seeing land grabs. This is what we saw at the Bundy Ranch. We were up there covering the Bundy Ranch. And it is a massive land grab under UN Agenda 21. And Clark County, where that ranch is, has signed on and is abiding to the climate action plans in UN Agenda 21, just as all of our cities and counties across the country and other countries have signed on to this. There's really nowhere that I have not found a climate action plan. The bankruptcy of the United States. Mr. Speaker, we are here now in Chapter 11. Members of Congress are official trustees presiding over the greatest reorganization of any bankrupt entity in the history, the U.S. government.